Today in the world of magic, we have changes to Commander products, a potential problem with Time Spiral Remastered, and some downright bizarre tweets by Wizards of the Coast. Owners of fine luxury cardboard rectangles, my friends, we have a range of things to talk about. I hope the day finds you well and you're ready to fill your belly with some delicious mega magic news. So, what do we have to talk about today? We have a change to Commander products, we have a potential problem that's going on with Time Spiral Remastered, and some really crazy tweets from Wizards of the Coast that have a bunch of people scratching their heads and going, what are you doing, guys? So let's start out, let's do it in that order, actually. So we'll start by talking about the Commander product changes, all right? Now, this is mostly a change based around the packaging that's involved, but with some tweaks as to the contents of the packaging as well, right? Like what you actually get inside of it. Now, it doesn't really change what makes the Commander deck itself, it's everything around that. So up until this point, when Wizards has done their like main Commander deck releases, remember, we're in a different kind of time now where in the past, we would see one Commander deck set released a year, right? And they would be like, here's Commander 2020, here's Commander 2021. But now, with every standard set we get, there are also Commander decks released. So there's the full-on Commander decks and Commander deck light. So that's what we'll call like the Commander decks from Zendikar Rising. You know where they only release two Commander decks and it's tied into the theme of the set, but they're not like full-on Commander decks with the oversized foil commanders and all that kind of stuff. So those are your Commander light decks. We're going to be talking about changes to the full-on Commander decks that up until now included oversized foil commanders. So they're changing the packaging first off. So you're gonna have two different variations of packaging depending on where you purchase your product from. And the contents of those packagings will, like what you get is mildly different depending on whichever one you choose to purchase. So when it comes down to these new Commander deck packages, now, instead of having the big oversized foil, they're going to have like a foil version of your commander printed on the box. But inside the box, they're going to have a oversized, I believe it's oversized, maybe not to the same degree, but it's going to be a non-foil, like thicker, more rugged version of your commander to use. Now, this doesn't replace the actual copy of the commander card. It is just changing the bonus commander card essentially into something that I guess is a little more manageable. Part of it is because now it's meant to fit into particular packaging, right? So when you buy these commander decks, if you buy them in the store, you're gonna get them in the bigger box with the big foil display on it. But if you want to now, online, you're going to be able to purchase a smaller box version of it that comes in a more nondescript, less flashy kind of packaging. Think like Secret Lair boxes. You know how they have like the little Planeswalker symbol on it, a few words on it, and that's it, and it's that little rectangular box? Well, that is what these Commander decks are going to be coming in going forwards. So there is a little bit of a tweak in terms of what you get, but not that much. The Commander decks will basically have, like all the Commander decks will have the Commander deck, the actual oversized card, and will include your double-sided tokens. When you buy the bigger box version, you'll also get a punch out sheet of like counters, similar, I imagine, to the punch out counters that we got for Ikoria and Amonkhet. And there also will be a divider. Now it comes along with a deck box that's designed to hold 100 magic cards sleeved as well. So overall, it's not that much of a change. You have the ability to buy a slightly scaled down version of the commander deck that just doesn't have the tokens and the divider, but you will end up paying a little bit less money for it. So this is part of Wizards of the Coast initiative to make their products a little more green and green friendly. Although let's be real, they still do Secret Lairs, which come in a giant box for four cards with a lot of extra packaging. So there's a part of me that's like, hey, we're going green. And it's like, you said the same thing with Modern Masters 20, what was it? Modern Masters 2017? The second Modern Masters. It came in cardboard deck boxes, which actually ended up beating up the cards. But that's neither here nor there. On the face of it, hey, if you want to make changes to make your packaging a little more environmentally sustainable, that's fine. They say in the same article that they're going to be doing more, but I mean, the secret lair thing really kind of throws that out the window in terms of the incredible amount of packaging that they give you for like four or five cards. But whatever. I'm going to move on to the next news item, which is Time Spiral Remastered has a potential problem. It has been reported to me that you can weigh packs of Time Spiral Remastered effectively, determining which packs contain foils. So if you're not familiar with this, this is actually a problem that used to plague Magic the Gathering, where if you had a digital scale, then you could actually take Magic the Gathering packs, weigh them on the scale, and there was enough of a weight difference that you could actually tell which packs have foil cards in them, because the foil cards get a different treatment, right? They get that somewhat metallic kind of sheet put on them, and there is enough of a differential in weight that a scale that can pick up tiny weight changes is easily able to help you sort out which has foil and non-foil stuff in it. I was actually really amazed when somebody told me about this concept, and I was like, there's no way. So I took a booster box, this is in the past. I took a booster box and I tried an experiment, and I was just like, wow, you can actually do it with a pretty good degree of accuracy. Now, Wizards of the Coast came up with what I thought was a pretty good fix for this, in that the token cards, the add insert cards that they put into booster packs, what they did was they varied the weight of the card stock that comes along in these token and add insert cards. And so what that does is it creates too much variability in the weight of packs. So you wouldn't be able to take the packs out and easily tell by putting them on the scale which ones have foils in them. So that's a fix that made this kind of a problem of the past. I can't actually remember exactly when the last set was printed where you could just go ahead and weigh the packs. But regardless, it's been reported to me that there have been successful tests of weighing Time Spiral Remastered packs for foils and actively finding the foils with a good degree of accuracy. Now, I haven't had a ton of these reports, so I can't say that this is an absolute certainty, but it certainly is worrying. And basically what this means is, beware, my friends, if you're going to purchase loose booster packs of Time Spiral Remastered, there is the possibility that depending on who you're dealing with, they have pre-weighed the packs and removed the ones with foils. And considering that the time-shifted foils are very, very rare, like time-shifted foils are the most attractive thing about Time Spiral Remastered in terms of unique things you can only get from Time Spiral Remastered, because these are cards that have been printed from older sets and they've been given, or not older sets, I should say, they've been printed from newer sets and given the old school border. So for a lot of these cards, it's literally the only way, actually not a lot of them, for every card that is time shifted, it's the only way to get them with that old frame. And in a booster box, you're going to see at most one or two of these foils per entire booster box. So as a result, these are very scarce, they are very valuable, they are very desirable. So if that is one of the things that you are aiming for and after, and you're getting packs that have been weighed, you're basically having your chances of getting that foil removed down to zero. So just be aware of that. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is the absolutely bizarre choices that are being made by Wizards of the Coast in terms of how they're handling tweeting out about the MPL and the Rivals League. So if you don't know, the MPL and the Rivals League are Magic's main, like, pro tour replacement focus. This is supposed to be the, like, aspirational league where I want to be an amazing Magic player. I'm going to join the ranks of these top players. So Wizards of the Coast has just basically gotten ready to do their next rotation, because I believe, now I could be wrong about this, but I believe it changes once a year. It used to be much clearer how all the Pro Tour stuff worked and everything worked, but they've changed it to the MPL and the Rivals League, and they've made so many changes on how things operate that I literally am not 100% sure how it works. But either way, they put out tweets talking about how different competitors have like left the MPL or are leaving the MPL, right? We're right at that rotation situation where the lowest rank pro player leagues individuals get sent downwards. They get demoted to the rookie leagues, to the rival leagues or whatever. So you've got these changing the guard. Some people are leaving the Rivals League. Some people are moving up to the MPL. Some people are moving down. All this is going on. So Wizards of the Coast, over on like their Magic Esports account, decided to do the whole like, we're sending them off. Goodbye to you. But here's the thing. It reads like obituaries. Like it literally reads like the competitors have passed on. They're no longer living amongst us. Like virtually every single farewell is written in a way where you're like, wait, this, what happened? What took all these people from us abruptly? Like it's written as obituaries, but that's just part of the bizarreness. Where it gets even more bizarre is when you look at one particular individual who is being demoted, and that is an individual whose Twitter name is Mythic Meebo. So the tweet that Esports put out says, goodbye to Mythic Meebo, the one true wielder of Embercleave. You made a more lasting impression than a brushfire elemental holding a sword. Now, here's the thing. This caused massive confusion because Mythic Meebo isn't known for using Embercleave. This didn't have, like, she didn't use Embercleave. And somebody actually, like, combed over a bunch of her old school tweets and could only really find tweets where she was trashing Embercleave and said she didn't like it. And so they wrote, like, an obituary style goodbye where they're like, you will forever be immortalized for a thing that you weren't actually responsible for. Like, dude, this is supposed to be your Magic Pro League. Like, literally, the person behind the tweet got this MPL competitor confused with a different member of the MPL League, okay? Like, this is even funnier when you take into account the fact that Wizards of the Coast created, like, an ad campaign concept where they made a YouTube video even. You can see it now if you want, where it's like, it's called They Will Know Your Name or whatever, right? That's literally the idea behind it. They will know your name. And it's this big, like, hype you up style video where they're like, yeah, you're gonna climb to the pinnacle of Magic success and everybody's gonna know your name and it's gonna be a big deal and get into our esports. And then you make it to the top of the MPL, like not the top of the MPL, I should say. You make it to the top, which is the MPL. The MPL is like the highest level of competitive play you can have in Magic the Gathering. This is what you're supposed to strive for. Attain this and they will know your name. And then literally the company running the game that runs the MPL doesn't know your name. They don't know who you are. They get you confused with somebody else and like eulogize you essentially talking about accomplishments that aren't yours. Talk about insulting. And also it kind of shows how little Wizards cares about the MPL, and it even gets worse from here, because on Reddit, where they're talking about all of this, right, a Wizards of the Coast employee comes in trying to clear things up and go, okay, here's why the problem happened. Here's what happened. They hire like an independent third-party individual to do these tweets. These tweets aren't done by anybody involved with the actual Magic Pro League. They're like, they will know your name. Well, I mean, not Gary. We hired Gary just to do the tweets, and Gary has a rule where he only spends 15 seconds looking at somebody and is like, yeah, they're all the same, right? I can't tell the difference between them. You did a great job with Embercleave, Veronica. And it's like, my name is Becky, and I don't even like Embercleave. What are you doing? So they just, Wizards, I don't, Toronto spends $10 for their MPL coverage, and it leads to this. You got tweets that read like obituaries written by somebody who didn't know the person who died. It's absolutely bizarre. And this is from a company that Hasbro has just elevated to being like a full-on, like full-fledged wing of their company, right? They're like a division now of Hasbro. And this is such an egg on your face moment. So obviously it's newsworthy. Figured you guys could enjoy a chuckle. I mean, ultimately, underneath it all, it's pretty harmless, but it's really absurd. Anyways, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you're enjoying yourself, hit the like, because that's good for the channel. And you know what else is good for the channel? Being a patron. So, top patrons scrolling on by, thanks for supporting the channel, my friends. I will see all of you tomorrow.